What's good, y'all? I'm coming back today, man. I know I haven't really been uploading that consistently on this channel with actual videos. I've been uploading a lot of music, and that's because I just been focusing on music more over these past, you know, like 2 months or so. I just been like on a music phase where I really want to focus on music and, you know, less on YouTube. And I just had like a lot of academic stuff going on. You know, I really got to focus on that. I have finals this week, but I got a question on my channel that I really wanted to answer because it's been sitting here for probably about 3 weeks, and basically it was a girl, and she's asking me to explain more about why I chose Iota Phi Theta Fraternity Incorporated. I if y'all don't know, I'm a brother of Iota Phi Theta Fraternity Incorporated. I crossed Fall 16, so I'm a Neo. I'm fairly new, but I'm just gonna break down the question and go into, you know, why I chose Iota out of like all the other fraternities that I had the option to, you know, possibly pursue or join. So her question says, word for word, it says, can you do a more in-depth video on why you chose to be an Iota without spilling any secrets or anything, but just give a better understanding of your history, on your history, and why there aren't many Iotas around? All right, so let me put it like this. For me, one big thing with Iota is it really was, you know, the brothers that I met were from all different backgrounds. They had different interests, they had different personalities, and they all, you know, were people who I felt like were really trying to make a contribution to society, and that's like a huge thing for me. I really wanted to be part of an organization that was going to be more than just, you know, me putting on letters and strolling and stepping, because you can, you know, that's, I mean, I hate to say it, but, you know, certain people do join orgs just for the like glamour effect, you know. So when they're in college, they just, you know, they like to be like, oh, I can stroll, I can step, I'm going to parties, you know, but there's a lot more to Greek life outside of that. And really, for me, brotherhood was a huge thing. So I did have the opportunity to meet people from other fraternities, and I just didn't click with them as much. You know, the chapter that I met here, the Zeta Theta chapter, the chapter I'm a part of, you know, all of them were like really cool people. You know, they really took interest in me, and they didn't only take interest in me, but they went out of their way to get to know me. You know, a lot of other orgs did not do that. And on top of that, you know, Iota is a very... It's the youngest organization in the NPAC. So when you're saying, give some history, the reason why there aren't as many Iotas, or you don't hear about Iotas as much, probably is because we're a younger organization. We're founded in 1963. A lot of these other, the other D9 orgs that you probably hear about a lot, Alpha Phi Alpha, you know, Omega Psi Phi, they were founded in like 1906, 1911. So they had a lot more time to kind of just develop into larger organizations. All right, so... we're relatively new. 1963 was not that long ago, and you know, so that explains the size factor. But you know, there's a lot of organizations where, like, I feel like are certain chapters, maybe I wouldn't say organizations as a whole, because I think there are people from diverse backgrounds in every org, but there's certain stereotypes, you know, for certain orgs, and you kind of have to kind of conform to that stereotype if you become a part of that organization, or it's hard to kind of be yourself when you're around people who are kind of all displaying the stereotype of that org. With Iota, there's no stereotype for us. You can ask anybody, you know, what is an Iota? What do Iotas do, you know? And they might just say, oh, you know, like they're the youngest or whatever. They're the smallest or whatever, or something like that. But like, they can never give you a stereotype. They can never say, well, an Iota is this, you know, an Iota can be anything. And that was something that just really pushed me to the next level. You know, it really settled it in my heart, and it made me know, or it just kind of not made me know, what am I talking about? It solidified my choice to pursue Iota Phi Theta Fraternity. And I'm beyond happy that I did. It's one of the greatest decisions of my life, and I'm still learning, I'm still growing, and still working, you know. This is a lifetime commitment, and yeah. So I think that's pretty much it. Hopefully I answered your question. Let me just look it over again, just to make sure I did. But yeah, man, that's why I chose Iota. I don't really think there's much else to it. If y'all have any more questions about Greek life and stuff in general, like, just leave comments below. I'd be more than happy to talk about my experience thus far and just kind of let you guys know where I'm at, my headspace, you know, what I've experienced, and, you know, some pros and cons, whatever. Whatever questions you guys have, man, just let me know. And if y'all wanna hear from somebody besides me, I could always get some of my frat brothers to, you know, do a video with me as well. And they can give you like a much broader perspective. All right, so hopefully I answered your question. I'm gonna have some more videos dropping soon as I get out of school. Finals is almost, you know, almost out the way. Once I get through this week, I'm lit. And it probably gonna be chill videos, man. I'm kind of, like I said, I was restructuring this channel. And they're probably just gonna be like me talking to the camera, because that's what I like to do most. I don't care if you guys don't like it. That's what's gonna happen, all right? So, yeah. Let me get back to studying. I'll catch y'all later. Peace.